Here we will explain the energy stored in a magnetic field and introduce equations for calculating the power, the work done, and the energy stored in the magnetic field of an inductor. Magnets and other magnetic materials store potential energy. This is true whether they are permanent magnets with a constant magnetic field or electromagnets, which need an electric current to pass through them to generate a magnetic field. Did you know that solar flares, intense explosions on the sun, actually result from this stored up magnetic potential energy being released? Here's a typical inductor, a current carrying coil. As current passes through it, work is done to establish a magnetic field around the inductor. The magnetic field stores energy, magnetic potential energy to be specific. When the current changes, the strength of the magnetic field varies, and therefore the amount of energy it stores differs too. The energy from the magnetic field can be released back into the circuit, inducing an electromotive force, EMF, in the conductor. EMF is also known as the induced voltage and represented by the Greek letter epsilon. The magnitude of the EMF, or the induced voltage, is equal to minus L times by di over dt, where L is the induced current or inductance of the inductor at a particular instant, and di over dt is the rate of change of current. Voltage is measured in volts. An induced current is measured in ampere. Don't forget the minus sign, which indicates that induced voltage is always opposite to the rate of change in the current. As the current passes through the inductor, an exchange of energy occurs. The rate at which energy is transformed is known as the power, and it's calculated by multiplying the induced voltage, epsilon, by the current, I. Power is measured in watts. Finally, let's derive the equation for energy stored in an inductor. The energy arising from a current at any given time is given as U. At any given time, dU equals negative power times dt. Swapping in the equation for power and simplifying, we see that the energy stored in the inductor is given by dU equals LiD. Say the current starts at zero and increases to UB. As the current changes, the circuit charges or discharges. Integrating over the change, we see that the energy stored in the inductor, UB, equals a half times by induced current times by current squared. L is measured in the units of Henry, and I is in ampere. With this equation, we can calculate the energy of any inductor's magnetic field. Do not assume that the energy stored in the inductor is directly proportional to the current. In fact, it is directly proportional to the square of the current. Let's try a worked example. Consider an inductor of inductance of 40H. The current flowing through the inductor is 2 amperes. Calculate the energy stored in the magnetic field of the inductor. Pause now if you want to try it on your own. Step 1 is to write the expression for the energy stored in the magnetic field of an inductor. Then, fill in the inductance, 40 Henry, and the current, 2 amperes, and solve. Hence, the energy stored in the magnetic field of an inductor is 80 joules. In this video, we've learned how energy is stored in a magnetic field and how to calculate its value. For more helpful videos like this, subscribe to the Chegg channel.